Future returning champion, Elgin Tensity, aka Trapokalemia. Alright, let's make these monthly Q&As monthly again. Without further ado, here's the first question. Will you ever show up to a fitness expo like the Arnold? Well, first, I'm really fucking glad your name's Eugene Smith and not Vince Garza, because he'd better not ever fucking see me at an expo. I'd like to set up a booth at a smaller expo, but I'd also like to go to a bigger expo like the Arnold or the Olympia as a guest. I really look forward to meeting the various YouTube celeries I've encountered online over the years, and seeing how retarded they are off camera. And of course, I'm trolling fools. With no shield of anonymity and no ability to block me, it'll be too much fun to pass up. So going to a fitness expo is definitely on my bucket list. Speaking of Venice, Chris asks, what is the swole nerd up to nowadays? I imagine he's up to his elbows in debt, to the ceiling even. After Chris Jones kicked him out of Physiques of Greatness, he partnered with another black guy named Chris, who was supposed to help him get lean for a show. I correctly predicted that this plan would fail, although predicting that Vince would fail at something is like predicting that a critical comment on the Tiger Fitness channel will end up in the spam filter. Then, at the beginning of this year, Vince left his comfort zone by teaming up with a black guy who isn't named Chris and working on a new channel. Vince's only job was editing, so viewers wouldn't be subjected to the potato Latin he calls English. But that, of course, didn't stop the trolls. Despite the fact that Vince had less to do than ever before, he and Chris Jones III haven't uploaded in 2 months. Vince didn't even bother to design a thumbnail for the last video, so he just used a screenshot of the YouTube player. Vince shirked his responsibilities after a breakup back when he was on POG, so I'm guessing he did the same with his new channel because the uploads came to a halt around the same time Vince went through another breakup. He obviously hasn't learned that real adults have to go to work even if we don't feel too great. Vince's partner seemed to think that there's no such thing as bad publicity, but as you can see, that doesn't apply to any project involving Vince Galactus, my favorite natty ravager of YouTube channels. Dave Engelberry asks, what game system or systems did you have growing up, and of which games do you have the fondest memories? Alright, my first console was the NES, and my first handheld was the Game Boy. Then I got a Super Nintendo, a Genesis, a Game Gear, and a PlayStation, or PSX as it was called at the time. In 4th or 5th grade, I got my first PC, which was an IBM PS1. I consider that a game system because that's pretty much the only reason I wanted a PC. In high school, I got a Neo Geo Pocket Color and a Dreamcast. I also built my first PC when I was a junior, again for gaming. In college, I got an Xbox, and after college, I got a PS3 and then a PS4. If I didn't get a console, I either didn't give a shit about it, like the Atari Jaguar and the 3DO, or I played games on it at a friend's house, which was the case with the PS2 and N64, so I just didn't need to buy them. My fondest memories were of getting together with friends and playing Brood War, Smash, and Street Fighter 2. I think we all enjoyed playing Oregon Trail on the Apple IIs during computer lab at school, and I fondly remember playing Resident Evil 1, especially when I shat myself after the dogs first broke through the windows of that hallway. There are way too many gaming mints to talk about in one video, so I'll address this again in future videos. I can talk about specific games or consoles just so it's more focused. What's your opinion on Nick's strength and power? I don't follow bodybuilding, but from what I've seen, his channel's decent. Like Louis Marcos without the thick accent or the catchphrases. Instead of going viral by talking about bubble gut and synthol freaks, he went viral by talking about fake plates. Even though he's doing extremely well, Nick might want to consider uploading less often to avoid overwhelming his audience. I know this is coming from someone who rarely ever uploads, but there are marginal returns to uploading 3 times a day, unless you're a news channel or some shit. I can understand if he uploads that often during the Arnold or the Olympia, but otherwise nobody needs that much bodybuilding info every day. His monthly views are god tier, for now anyway, but not due to his high upload frequency. It's possible to upload less often and get as many views, if not more. Besides, the most important metric on YouTube when it comes to earnings is watch time, and it's harder to achieve high watch time when subscribers don't get to every video. Regardless of how often he uploads, I definitely salute him for calling out bullshit in the fitness community. The real Josh Burns, who ironically isn't verified and isn't sporting any burns, asks, do you secretly roast people at your law office, similar to the street roasts? If you don't follow me on social media, then you might not know that I occasionally upload videos of myself roasting people I see when I'm out and about. It's actually harmless target practice because you can't see their faces, and they generally can't hear me. As for whether I'd do something like that at work, abso-fucking-lutely not. Recording myself roasting coworkers, even if they're subordinates, will come back to haunt me one day. I might send the video to somebody who leaks it, or someone at the office might overhear me and spill the beans. Street roasts at work could easily get my ass fired, and I don't want to be homeless, which you would know if you've seen my street roasts. Soggy Unicorn, who hopefully has no relation to Gender Unicorn, asks, what does your tricep training consist of if you do any direct work? I don't do direct triceps work. I flat bench twice a week. On one day, I follow up the flat bench with incline bench, and on the other day, I follow up with close grip. Because of all the benching I do, I don't see the need for more triceps work. Pain Train, not to be confused with Chaos in Pain, which is a pain in the ass if your name's Tucker James, asks, what would you be doing if you weren't a lawyer? I'd probably be a financial advisor. I've been investing in stocks and bonds since I was 15, through a custodial account, of course. So I was interested in investing at a young age. When I was in New York for college, I had a part-time job at AXA Advisors, and my boss would have put in a good word for me there once I passed my Series 7. My boss actually quit practicing law to become a financial planner, and when I told him about wanting to go to law school, he said to have passive income so I'm not only making money when I'm at the office. So I probably would have had a YouTube channel or something similar to it on the side as well. Hey yo, Traptimus Prime, what is your favorite kind of sushi? Also, how many rolls do you typically eat in one sitting? Favorite sushi, I like uni, which is sea urchin, saba, which is mackerel, and unagi, which is eel. The number of rolls I eat in one sitting depends on where I'm sitting. If I'm at the sushi bar, I'll typically cap it off at 4, so 24 to 32 pieces. If I'm at the buffet, price is lower, so I'll eat at least 4. And according to this picture from 2014, my record is 55 pieces. Did you play any trading card games when you were younger? Examples being Magic the Gathering, Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokemon. Yeah, I played Magic the Gathering and Star Wars the Customizable Card Game in junior high. I started playing Magic with the Ice Age set and stopped after Weatherlight. I started playing Star Wars with the Premier set and stopped after Jabba's Palace. I didn't play Pokemon, the card game, because I preferred the handheld games. And I briefly played Marvel Overpower, but the game was boring to me and the art wasn't as good as it was on the Masterpiece cards I collected. I didn't play card games at all in high school, and I ended up selling all my cards to comic book stores before I left for college. So shoutouts to Inquest magazine for helping me get the best prices. Another The Real account, so extra. If I'm not the biggest guy in the gym, but want to show that I'm better than all of them, what do I do? The big guys get really insecure if you tell them that they squat high or otherwise cheat a lift, especially if they're on gear. They'll go absolutely apeshit. That'll knock them down a few pegs on the internet, let alone in person. Otherwise, you can go to the gym when nobody else is there, so you'll be the biggest guy by default. A wise man once said, sometimes nobody shows up and you automatically win. Not sure if Jose is early with the Christmas decorations or he never put them away. I recently got into mechanical watches. Any general advice to start a small watch collection? You should start with a diving watch, because it's the most versatile, and pick up some straps to change the look until you can afford another watch. Second, pick a watch that's appropriate for the stage of your career. If I see a 20-something intern, for example, wearing a Rolex, I'm going to assume A, his parents bought it for him, or B, it's a Fugazi. Either way, I won't think much of him. My first mechanical watch was a chronograph that I got for a little over $1,000 when I found out I passed the bar exam. I just needed something sensible to wear to work. So buy a diver for starters, and don't look like a cheapskate or a pretentious douche. What did you think of E3 2017? Any games you're looking forward to? I'm most looking forward to Metro Exodus next year. The enemies will apparently change with the seasons, which is great because I didn't really care for the enemy variety in Metro 2033 and Metro Last Light. I'm also interested in Age of Empires Definitive Edition, which is a 4K version of the original. And for PS4, I want to get Red Dead Redemption 2 and Kingdom Hearts 3. This is all assuming I have any money left after the Steam summer sale. What do you think of resistance bands in general, not as an option for weights? If you're asking what I think of them as standalone tools as opposed to accommodating resistance, I think they're effective, especially for smaller muscles. Every evening after work, I take a thin red resistance band and do pull-aparts. This helps me a lot because I tend to hunch forward at my desk. It's worth a try if you sit for many hours a day, whether you're loading ammo or you're employed. Think about it. Just think about that for a minute. Who do you want, McGregor or Floyd? And a bunch of similar questions. I want McGregor to win because I think he's a better shit talker and it would make a better story than Floyd beating a guy in his pro boxing debut and staying at a perfect record. That won't happen because Floyd always makes sure he wins, but upsets are inherently more interesting. It would be like a simpleton winning a junior high spelling bee when he's dumber than a sixth grader. Alright, fuckos, it's time for the lawyering round. Let me adjust my glasses for a moment. Death by Bukkake or 4 seconds of dialogue with the Navy SEAL Lord CrossFit himself? Why are these always so fucking nasty? I'll talk to anybody for 4 seconds, even Dave Castro, rather than drown in a flood of knuckle children. The following are door-to-door salesmen. What do they try to sell you? Cali Muscle, Venice G, Armchair Merc, Every Damn Day, and Logical Bro. Cali Muscle will sell me bras made specifically for bitches with bizarre downward-pointing nipples. Logical Bro will sell me men's wigs and soggy bandanas. Venice G will sell me like-new camera equipment. In other words, the camera equipment from his POG days. Every Damn Day will sell me soundproofing foam and pre-cooked lobsters. And the Armchair Merc will sell cuck sessions with his girlfriend, the Joker. Like the video and subscribe to the channel, now.
Everybody drugs them bodies sometime. Everybody tries the gear somehow.